So we are doing the MCQs from the poem ball. So we were talking about like what kind of loss is there. It's a loss of, literally it's a loss of dash. Yes, ball or bag or pencil or pen. So literally here the poet is talking about the loss of ball. And this loss of ball is of dash kind. Materialistic kind. The loss of ball is of materialistic kind. It's a materialistic loss. The law, materialistic things make us get dashed with them, attached. And this attachment is the source of dash, sadness or grief, you know? Sadness or grief. Attachment is a source of sadness or grief. It's not the ball itself. Ball is not a source of sadness. The loss of ball is also not a you know, means of sadness for us, but our attachment with the ball makes us sad. So it's about the dash baggage which we carry in the end makes us sad. Which baggage? Is it emotional baggage or psychological baggage or listen to my options now. Each time, don't expect the answer to be same in all situations. It would depend upon the kinds of options which I'll be giving. So it is the dash baggage which makes us sad in the end. Emotional baggage, psychological baggage, materialistic baggage, or spiritual baggage. Is it the materialistic baggage which makes us sad in the end? Emotional or psychological? Emotional, yes. Here in this poem, is the boy emotionally attached with the ball or psychologically attached? Emotionally. How can we say this? Because sadness is somewhat related with emotion. Okay, and even we'll discuss otherwise also. Psychological also you could have talked about, but here emotions will come because he is emotionally attached with the ball because he has got memories with about it. So memories are about emotions. Right? Okay, now the next question is. So when the poet says, what is the boy now who has lost his ball? So what does the poet mean by this? What is the boy now? What does the poet mean by this? What is the boy now? Options are, yes, give the option number one, Ashin. What is the boy now? Give the distractor, not the correct option. What is the boy now? What does the poet mean by this? What is the boy now? Is it a distractor? From your side, is it a distractor or a real answer? Okay. Yes, Thavnesh. What's the boy now? This tractor I want. But you people are, I'm asking you the literal meaning of the what's the boy now? If you are to explain what does this line mean, what will you say? Yeah, that is the in the end theme. In the end, the loss has made the boy grown up. Okay, you are grown up when you learn how to tackle the loss, how to manage the loss, how to deal with the loss. That is the end answer and theme of the poem. Yeah. So the poet is asking, what's the boy now who has lost his ball? So what does the poet want to say? What's the boy now? Options are number one, Khushi, yes? No? Real answer. Hmm. condition. What's the condition of the boy? So what's his status? What's the condition of the boy now? So is he sad? Is he, has he, you know, learned to deal with it or not? Or is he still struggling to cope up with the loss? Last venture. Now you won't get just one idea about the answers. What is the boy means? The poet is asking, like, what's the status of the boy now? Is he sad? Or has he learned to cope up with the loss? Got it? What's the boy now means? How is he now? Is he still sad or has he learned to cope up with the loss? This is the meaning of the poem. This is the meaning of this line. What's the boy now? What does it mean? What does it mean, Garima? Yes, so the poet is making sure, or the poet is asking if the boy is still sad or has he learned to cope up with the loss. Got it? And distractors can be anything. What's the boy now means, number one. What's the boy doing? What is the job of the boy? Or what's the profession of the boy? Number three, what's the status of the boy? If he is still sad or has he learned to manage the loss? And fourth option, what's the boy doing nowadays? So third option is correct one. Got it? So you should know the literal meanings of the lines. So what's the boy now? Here it means, like, what's the, whether the boy has learned to be, learned to deal with the loss. The one who has lost his ball. What is he to do now? What is he to do? Write down. What is he to do? What is he to do? So what does the poet mean by this? What is he to do? So it means, what's the correct answer, Tarundi? What is he to do and what is he to supposed to do? You've just added one word, supposed. Try to explain. Yes. What is he doing? Okay, let it be a distractor. What is he doing? Lie down. Okay, Tarun, sit down. Yes, next girl. Yes. Yes. Imani. What's her name? Ankita. Imani, your turn will also come. Yes, Ankita. What is he to do? It's simple line. What is he to do? Yes. Yes. So, well, is it a distractor or real answer? Therein lies your, achievement. So, is it the distractor or the real answer? Distractor, Khushi? Okay, tell what's the then real answer? Yes. So, what is he to do now? What is he to do means, like, what will be his reaction? He has lost something, and after loss, how will he manage? How will he deal with the loss? If you say, how will he deal with the loss, is about the reaction you are anticipating. Okay, so here in this line, the poet is anticipating the kind of reaction the boy will show after the loss of the ball. This is the real answer. Distractors can be whatever you people will speak. isn't it? Okay, so what is he to do? So I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street. I saw it, sit down beta Ankita. So I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over. There it is in the water. So who saw the boy lost the ball? The boy lost the ball, right? Did the boy see where the ball had gone? Did the boy see or did the boy know where the ball had gone? Yes or no? The poet did mention. My question is, did the boy know that, did the boy know where the ball had gone? Let me read out the poem in brief for all of you, those who don't have the books. So try to give the answer, like, did the boy know where the ball had gone? I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over. So there it is in the water. No use to say, oh, there are other balls. An ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down all his young days into the harbor where his ball went. I'm repeating the lines. So no use to say, oh, there are other balls. An ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down all his young days into the harbor where his ball went. What is a harbor? Harbor is a place where the ships stop. So harbor is a port, guys. So he stands rigid. He kept on looking at the harbor. The play. So did he know where his ball had gone? Yes, he knew this. Who is I? I is poet. So is somebody observing the boy when his ball was, rolling towards that harbor? Yes, the poet was observing this. So did the poet try to help the boy? No. Why didn't the poet try to help the boy by stopping his ball or by taking the ball out of the harbor or by giving him a new ball? Yes, Naina? Yes, because he wanted the boy to learn to tackle the loss, to deal with the loss. Why did he want him to learn this? Because in one's life, one has to bear the losses. And the loss can be of any kind. It can be materialistic loss. It can be a personal loss. It can be the loss of some near and dear one. So if the children are not trained to tackle or deal with the losses right from their childhood, they may not be able to live a meaningful life. Okay, so that responsibility should come in children right from the childhood. So the poet wants that he should learn to deal with the loss right from his childhood. So he doesn't help him out. Okay, now next question is, in what ways could the poet have helped the boy? In what ways could the poet have helped the boys? Options are in two ways, in one way, in three ways, in five ways. In how many ways the poet could have helped the boy? Two ways. What are they? Yeah, he could have stopped the ball. And third, second, yes, consoling. He might console him. I think he might console him. Consoling is not help. Okay, when your friend loses a pen, you say, doesn't matter. You'll get some pen. Your parents will let you have one more. Don't worry. and your parents also tell you, don't worry, you've lost your pen, never mind, that's it. So is it the way they are helping you? They just say, okay, you will be, never mind, don't worry, it's okay. Bus. Is it a help? No, it's an emotional help. It's a psychological help. Okay, I had asked some other way, like my options were like, in how many ways could the poet have helped the boy? The answer was like in one or two or three ways. One was he could have helped him out in taking out the ball. Secondly, he could have helped him emotionally. Third, he could have given him money to buy one more ball. Three ways, right? If supposing options were one, two, and five, then what would have been your answer? Two then. One was like by taking out the ball, second by giving him money. That's it. Okay, because they are tangible helps. Yes. Then three. Okay, but you won't get this kind of very, very subjective question. You won't get. Okay, the questions would be such where there would be a proof in the text. Okay, and moreover, whenever you get confused regarding the options like this, then you choose the most objective option. Okay, to the point option, where you'll have the proof from the text. Getting? But yes, at some cases, for example, when we were doing the chapter 100 dresses, then we discussed so many questions which were all about one's which were from the psychological point of view. Okay, there also you have to go for facts, not opinions. So remember, there is a big, ideology behind all the questions. One is fact and the other is opinion. Go for facts. All MCQs will have some fact behind them. Okay, try to search that fact from the text which you would have read. So read the text very carefully. That's the key in all subjects. One is like read the text, and after every, behind every point, you should know the logic or the fact. Maybe it is science, maybe maths, maybe English, whatever. Next question is, I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street. What does merrily mean here in this line? The poet saw the ball go merrily bouncing down the street. What does merrily mean here? Options are happily, smoothly, uninterruptedly, or did I say happily? Okay, without any obstruction. Options are without any obstruction, merrily, smoothly. What did I say? One more? Uninterruptedly. Without any interruption. So repeat the options, Harshin. Smoothly. Okay, so what do you think is the correct answer? Merrily here doesn't at all mean happily. Okay, because the ball cannot be happy. Okay, or anything else? Uninterruptedly or without any obstruction. So what's the most suitable, you think? Interruption can be by human being also. So without any obstruction. On the way, there wasn't any pebble, stone. Otherwise, the ball might have stopped. So merrily it went off means without any obstruction, the ball went off into the harbor. Okay?